saying I say something to him, huh? Huh? But his wife whispers very softly, yes,
well,
dear.
I better hear her. It doesn't matter.
So we get in the car right out of the airport. On the way to Universal, call the guy we know and goes, what? Stan's coming? But how long? I go, you got about 15 minutes before we get to your door. It was the funniest thing, man. Everybody's like running around. And then, look, all we gotta do is just walk in, guys. No, no, it's Stan Lee. And I go, yeah, but he's a normal guy. You work for him? And I go, yeah, he's a guy.
That so, guy is a good judge of character.
And it's so funny, once we walk in, we go through a backside area, and then we get into the public. And we barely hit this boulevard, I would call it. This kid yelled like, oh my God, it's Stan! I said, shut up. He just like, when that freaking out, like, oh my God, it's all I need. We walk in there, and then everybody's like, just, it's like one of those frozen in time, they're like, oh my God, Stan Lee.
Well, welcome to the Max Anderson show.
It's so funny. If you guys want to see it, nobody, my friends are telling me, he's not there, he's not there. We got the Marvel characters together, and we put it on Facebook. And I put it on, I don't use Facebook, but I put it on Facebook. It's under Max Anderson. You'll see it. And he's there hanging out. Everybody's having a good time. Then, you know what, Max? I want to go on a ride. The last time he was here, he went on the Hulk ride. You talk about my heart doing this. My buddy tells me, Max, if something happens to him, do you know what's going to happen to you?
Imagine what would happen to me.
And so,
anyway, it was nice being here, and I hope you do this again.
Anyway, check out the but we're going to do a little funny game, because the last time we went at the convention, he wanted, because we always take turns, you guys take turns asking him questions, and he always gives you an answer. The last one, he wanted to ask you guys questions, see who gets the right answer.
Yeah, wouldn't that be a good idea? At a panel, instead of the people on stage answering questions, we'll ask you questions, and anybody who doesn't know the answer gets kicked out of here. We don't get around because we're from Marvel. But I can't think of any questions. I'll tell you the question that is most often asked me. I know you lay in bed at nights wondering what question is most often asked Stan. I'm going to tell you. Go to a convention, go to a panel. All right, time for questions. One guy walks up to the microphone. I know what he's going to say. Here it comes. Who's your favorite superhero? And if I say anything but Spider-Man, they all get up and walk out.
Stan, speaking of Spider-Man, we got some very special security for you at this last Florida appearance. We've got him right here on stage.
Oh, my God. Superhero. Now, I don't know if you've ever thought of this. Spider-Man, like most of the Marvel characters, has a nickname. They don't always go Spider-Man, they go Spidey. Now, have you ever heard of Soupy or Fatty? This is why Marvel rules.
What was the question?
is fun. There is nothing more fun than being with fans, especially if they're your fans. I mean, if you were DC fans, it wouldn't be as much fun. I wake up in the morning and I say, is there a fan somewhere that I've missed? And I go hunting for him or her.
Honestly, that's funny because he says that there might be 100 people in the room and one guy will say, hey, who's a true believer? Everybody will raise their hand and say, that guy didn't make his hand up.
Hey, that brings another thing to mind that's very important. He used the expression true believer. Now, I will admit, I have used that once or twice. Nobody has ever asked me, what is it we believe? We're true believers, but what is it we believe? We never discuss. I want to have a panel someday to discuss what true believers believe. Is that all right? Do we get it?
Made him into the
young teenager kid that he wanted.
That is not to be taken as a criticism no. of Jack Kirby, who was the best. I wanted Peter Parker to be just an ordinary kid. And Jack, who loves to draw superheroes, when he drew him, he made him look like a heroic kid. I mean, made him strong and determined looking. And I wanted a guy who was just a schlep like I used to be. So Steve Ditko is good at drawing schleps. We never knew this was going to be so important. So I said, forget it, Jack. Well, let Steve do it. And that was it. Was that what you were talking about?
Yeah.
Did I explain it beautifully?
Yeah.
I had that ability. I explain things so beautifully. I fascinate myself while I'm talking. All right, go ahead.
Let's go to the next question.
How do you know who to point to? How's that? I was going to say,
let's
give you a sense of power. There are all those hands, and you decide who you're going to point to.
Well, that's something.
All right, anyway, who did you point to?
Right there.
Hi, Mr. Lee, my name is Bryce. I have a couple of short questions.
A couple of short questions. Maybe a couple of short questions is better than one long one.
What the hell was up with the Princess Diaries 2 cameo, and what's it like meeting Julie Andrews?
wife will make her think, yeah, maybe I better keep my eye on this guy, I don't know. And that didn't come across as funny as I thought it would. I'm going to just write that story and look on to the next thing. Go ahead. You have to level them. That's why they love me, because I level with them. I tell you, if I say something,
Galaxy 2.
that these guys are going to go ballistic. I explained it to him. He's like, that's brave. Wait until I get home and tell him. Joni is like, can't tell her.
See, what I'm shooting for, eventually I want a Marvel movie to star me.
Before take out the trash. But no, it's so funny, honestly, guys. It'll be coming out. I'll have it on some kind of YouTube channel. But honestly, for the last 3 years, 4.5 years maybe, we've been recording everything. And one funny moment, he'll tell you, when we went to go see one of the Iron Man movies, we're in part of the theater, and it's him and his daughter, me, and another guy. And all of a sudden, coming down the corridor, I see Robert Downey Jr. coming in. And I'm like, oh, shit, here it goes. He comes in, and his security details right there, and they go like that, and they go like that, and they go like this, and they go like this. And I'm like, okay, so the first thing the guy said, everybody put away their camera. I said, no, no one's going to tell me to put away the camera. Robert comes in, and the first, I mean, honestly, God, I got it on film, too, to prove it. The guy comes in, stands sitting right there, and he just literally...
I wouldn't know why he's so surprised. Everybody knows
that. But it was so awesome to see that. I mean, because he was genuinely just humbled. He just, damn, you changed, I think it was Iron Man 2, you changed my life forever. And it was just, if you, once you see it, you'll know what I mean, because it's a strong bond that they did right there. And the same thing with Chris Evans introduced you to his parents. And his parents kept, you did this for my son, I can't believe it. And it was big.
Look what I did for Donald Trump. Think of how to turn my underwear inside out. I'm gonna find out who wrote that, and then I'm gonna talk.
too. I guess I'll have to think of something else. Taking back to your early days at Marvel, can you tell us about any unused characters that just didn't make the final cut? Anything that was too weird or too, just not good enough?
I heard your final day, your first days at Marvel, but I couldn't tell the rest.
Back in the day when you were at Marvel.
Yeah.
You got different characters.
Yeah.
There were some characters that you did create, but you never used it. Did you say a lot about them?
No, everybody I created I used. Because I'm not going to let anything go to waste. It's kind of frustrating now because I used to come home from work and I'd run in, after I said hello to my wife, I'd run into my room, get to the computer, and start writing and try to come up with new ideas for characters or stories. I don't do that anymore. And I kind of miss it, I think. But now other people, did you see, what's that newest one we have, Deadpool? I think that is so good, and it kills me that I didn't create it. And there's one line in it, where I forget the exact words, but there's a whole bunch of guys with guns pointed at him. And he says, I've got 12 bullets, whatever. I've only got 12 shells. You guys will have to share. To me, that's one of the cleverest lines I have ever heard, ever read. And I wish I had created. I have so many frustrations. I didn't create Wolverine. I didn't create the one I just told you about. I forgot the name already. And there's probably another one somewhere I didn't create. And I don't like the idea that there are things I didn't create. But there's nothing I can do about it.
Thanks. I also wanted to say you were great in Trial of the Incredible Hulk in 1989.
Unique. There must be thousands of people who have the same taste. But writers who tried to write for people of different age groups than theirs. And I don't know why they bother. Just write for yourself. Write a story you would enjoy reading. And there have to be a lot of people who have the same taste as you. So the only, by the way, was I asked for tips on writing or am I on the wrong subject? What advice? I would just write stories that I thought were good, that I would like to read. Luckily, the stuff I wrote, there are people, apparently, who have the same taste that I do. I congratulate them. I like the fact that the characters have become part of our country's culture. I mean, everybody knows the Hulk when you get angry. Everybody knows Spider-Man. And I think that's wonderful. Everybody knows Iron Man. What was the question?
Okay, two more questions, guys. We gotta go.
Hi, Stan. Could you please share with us another one of your favorite stories about working with Jack Kirby?
Artist would look at it and then make a change. play something up, subdue something. Not Jack. It was all in his mind, and he did it so easily, it seemed. It just flowed from him. I've never seen an artist draw figures or scenes the way Jack did. And that's when I decided to give him the nickname King, Jack King Kirby. Because to me, he really was the king of the artists who drew these comics. And that wasn't funny. Why didn't I make it funny?
Because of the books that I read.
And I would have liked to have been an actor. I think I would have, if I was a little bit, a real actor.
You put everybody out of business. That's why they gave you that cameo.
That's right, I'm in more Marvel movies than anybody. Did we tell them my new idea that I want to do cameos in the comics?
Yeah.
And then I want to do cameos in other people's things. All right, that's enough. We've been here long enough. You're probably all getting itchy and thinking, do they